Wyoming Food for Thought Project started 6.5 years ago as a local solution to hunger. Our dream was to create a mechanism for every single person in our community, but especially children, to have access to good and healthy food year-round.
So we started our business here in Wyoming, partly because Ben's born and raised here. I moved here from Wisconsin about 7 years ago, and we both fell in love with food. And that led to raising goats and making your own cheese, because why wouldn't you do that?
Currently, I'm working on a project called Growing Resilience, which is bringing 100 gardens to tribal members on the Wind River Indian Reservation, which is home to the Northern Arapaho and Eastern Shoshone people. We've been doing that for 3 years. We have over 365 tribal members that have actually been through the project and planted a garden. Food is a catalyst for bringing families together, bringing communities together. It's something like we all agree on that we need to change, because now we're relating one thing to the other, and we're starting to know, like, if we're gonna eat this, you know, food, we gotta make it healthier, you know, we gotta make healthier decisions.
Food really brings people together, especially food.
Our gardens are a mechanism for our community to come kind of on a level playing field, because we don't have fences and it's really open to every single person, no matter your income or your ability.
We like to allow folks to come out to the farm and pet the baby goats and any little niche you can find to, like, kind of help everybody come together. It just really feels good.
With the gardeners, they have family members who look at the garden and they started a garden. And so it's reciprocal, and people talk about it, because the word of mouth on the reservation is stronger than anything. And if you're out there doing something and people see it, that's, you know, tangible. That's something they can see and build off of.
Our volunteer opportunities with our weekend food bags, our bag packings, our food drives are a mechanism for anyone 0 to 110 to come volunteer, be a part of something bigger than themselves. We do see our work bringing people together, and the most visual way that you can see that is when you come to the farmers market.
We really feel like the farmers market really contributes to a sense of community. It gives people a place to come and connect with their food and connect with their neighbors and their farmers, and it also really helps keep money in our local economy.
We have SNAP users, we have business owners, we have sponsors, we have just everyday shoppers. Our farmers markets are really just like a cross-section of our community.
In order for us to live healthier, longer, happier lives, we have to take control of our own food system, of our own health, of our own, you know, our own community, and make it a better place, because nobody, the government isn't going to come in and do that for us.
You know, it helps diversify our local economy. It helps bring in food security to a lot of local folks, and it helps people connect to where their food comes from. I think that's super important.
The fantasy side, I would love to see us, you know, develop a sustainability plan where we become a whole self-sustainable tribe. Realistically, as long as it's facilitated and there are people there to foster the movement, it'll keep going, you know. All we got to do is just keep coming with ideas, keep making sure people have their seeds, they have, you know, whatever they need.
Well, I have no idea where I'm going to see myself in 20 years, but I really hope that the local food movement in Wyoming really flourishes and grows, and that it helps diversify our economy. And we value open spaces, and one of the ways to keep it open is through agriculture.
So really what we're trying to do is demonstrate that this can be done. Local ag just opens up so many doors that otherwise aren't even there.